weight related problems. Hey kids, in this video, we will learn about measuring items with weighing scale and adding different weighing stones to measure the weight. Today, Gopal and his daughter Neetu are going to sell junk at Birju uncle's shop. On seeing Gopal and Neetu, Birju uncle gets happy.
Oh, nice. Gopal bhaiya, today you have brought our daughter with you.
Yes, uncle. Nowadays, she is helping me a lot with my work.
Wow, this is a good thing. Well, say, what have you brought today?
Uncle, here is some newspapers, some old books, and some cans of bottles.
Give it to me. Let me weigh them.
Hey, why is Neetu looking here and there? She is looking a bit shocked too.
What happened, Neetu? What are you looking for?
How will Birju uncle weigh all this? He doesn't even have a weighing machine.
Oh, child, you are so intelligent. Yes, I don't have any machine, but I will weigh without it.
How come, uncle?
Look, this is known as weighing scale.
Yes, kid, we can also measure with the help of weighing scale.
Uncle, please, show me how to do this.
But, uncle, I have some other works in the market too.
Never mind, bhaiya. You finish your work. Let her stay with me. I will teach her how to use it.
Uncle, how can we measure with this? It has no needle to point at numbers.
Yes, not a pointer like that. But we do have a small needle along with these two plates. Look here. Right now, both of these plates are empty and the needle is facing towards the center, which means the needle is balanced because both the plates are of equal weight. We use weighing stones to measure weight in a weighing scale.
Weighing stones? What are these?
Look, these are weighing stones.
Oh my God, how many are these? And look, this one is so big.
Yes, this is the biggest weighing stone I have. Look how much is written on it.
100 kilograms.
Yes, it means this weighing stone weighs 100 kgs. Now check out other weighing stones and tell me their weights.
Apart from 100 kilograms, we have 50, 20, 10, 5, 2, and 1 kg. Oh, we have weighing stones smaller than 1 kg too.
Yes, these are stones weighing in grams. Look, 500 grams, 200 grams, 100 grams, and 50 grams. These are weighing stones which weigh less than this too, but I don't use them.
Okay, uncle, how do we measure weight with the help of these?
I will show you. Let's weigh the newspaper you have brought. Can you guess how much it will weigh?
Uncle, it was quite heavy. I couldn't even lift it. It must be around 10 kgs.
Okay, let's weigh this with the weighing stone of 10 kilograms. For measuring weight, we will place the item to be weighed on one side and will keep on putting weighing stones on the other until the needle points at the center or get balanced. Look, the side carrying 10 kg weighing stone moved downwards. while the side carrying the newspapers moved upwards. This means the weight of the newspaper is less than 10 kgs.
Uncle, what should we do now?
We will put stone which weighs less than 10 kgs. So can you tell me which weighing stone is smaller than 10 kgs?
5 kgs.
Let's place this.
Uncle, now the side carrying the newspaper has moved downwards.
Which means?
This means that the weight of the newspaper is more than 5 kgs.
Yes. So what should we do now?
I don't know, Uncle. We don't have any stone which weighs more than 5 kgs and less than 10 kgs.
Now we will add smaller weighing stones to this. Let's check by adding weighing stone of 2 kgs.
Yes. Oh look, the side carrying weighing stones has moved downwards. Means the weight of the newspapers is less than 5 plus 2, 7 kgs.
Yes. Now let's replace the 2 kg weighing stone by 1.
Uncle, look! Now the sides are balanced and the needle also points at the center.
That means the weight of the newspapers is
5 and 1 means 6 kilograms.
Very good! Now weigh these books on your own. These are not that heavy.
Okay, Uncle.
See, I have placed the books on this side.
Let's place weighing stone of 2 kgs first. Oh, this is still on the upper side. Means I have to add some more weighing stones. Let's add one more stone of 1 kg to it. Means now it becomes 2 and 1, 3 kgs. Oh wow, this is balanced now. This means the weight of the books is 3 kgs.
Look, your father has also come.
So, uncle, did she disturb you?
No, no. She is a very sweet child.
Dad, I have learned how to measure weight using stones and weighing scale. Look, these books weigh 3 kgs.
Very good, Neetu.
In this video, we have learned about measuring items with weighing scale and adding different weighing stones to measure the weight. Weight-related problems. Common mistakes. Hey kids, in this video, we will learn about some common mistakes while measuring weight using the weighing scale. Come, let's see what Neetu is doing today. She has put some stones on the weighing scale and is looking a bit worried. Birju uncle is looking at her.
Hey kid, what happened? What are you doing?
Uncle, see, I'm placing the weighing stones on both the sides. Still, the needle is not getting balanced.
This is because weight on both the sides is different.
No, Uncle, look. This is of 1 kg and this is of 100 grams. Both are equal, right?
Okay, Neetu. Try to lift both of them. While doing this, don't you feel the weight is different?
Yes, Uncle, you are right. I haven't thought about this. But how is this possible?
Because you are forgetting that 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams, not 100 grams.
Oh, yes, Uncle. How did I forget this? 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams, not 100 grams.
Right. Now place some more weight on the side, carrying 100 grams, so that it becomes equal to 1000 grams, and the scale gets balanced.
Okay, uncle. To this 100 grams, I am adding 500 grams, then 200 grams, then 100 grams, and the last two stones of 50 grams each. Yes, now the total is 1000 grams. Look, uncle, the scale is now balanced.
Very good.
So, kids, now you understood. 1 kg is not equal to 100 grams. Instead, it is equal to 1000 grams. Oh, look, Birju uncle is asking something from Neetu.
Neetu, if I place a 1 kg stone one side and a 2 kg stone on another side, can you tell me which side of the weighing scale will move upwards?
The side carrying 2 kgs.
How come?
Because this side carrying 2 kgs is heavier than the other.
Yes, child. The side carrying 2 kgs is more heavy than the side carrying 1 kg. But don't forget, the heavier side always moves down.
Uncle, I have not understood this.
Okay, I will teach you. Remember, when you swing in the seesaw with Shyam, he automatically moves downwards and you move upwards, right?
Yes, uncle, because Shyam is heavier than me. That's why he moves downwards.
Yes, absolutely right. In the similar way, in this weighing scale, the side carrying more weight moves downwards, while the side carrying less weight moves upwards because it is lighter than the other.
Yes, uncle, I have understood. The side having more weight will move downwards. This means in this case of 1 kg and 2 kg weighing stones, the side carrying 1 kg will move upwards because it is lighter than the other.
Exactly. Now you have learnt it properly.
So kids, have you understood? In weighing scale, heavier weight moves downwards and lighter weight moves upwards.
In this video, we have learnt about some common mistakes while measuring weight using the weighing scale. Between kilograms and grams. In this video, we will learn about the measuring units of weight and the relationship between kilograms and grams. Come, today let's go to Gopal's house. Look how the three kids of Gopal, Shyam, Neetu and Mohan are playing together.
Brother, please swing me too.
Oh my God, Neetu, you have become too heavy.
Am I heavier than Mohan too?
Yes, you will be about 5 kgs heavier than Mohan.
What is kilogram, brother?
Come, I will teach you. Look, Neetu, when we measure the weight of an object, we measure it in the units of kilogram and gram. Kilogram is also known as kg.
Okay.
You have heard it, right? When mother brings 1 kg of tomatoes or potatoes from the market.
Yes, brother.
And kilogram is used to measure large quantities of an object, while gram is used to measure small quantities of it.
Okay, brother, like 1 kilogram of peas and 250 grams of chili powder?
Absolutely correct, Neetu. And do you know, 1 kilogram is equal to 1,000 grams.
These many grams?
Yes. Do you remember when we bought 250 grams of jalebis yesterday?
Yes, brother.
Now tell me, if we take 4 packets of 250 grams of jalebis, then what would be the total weight of all the jalebis?
250 plus 250 plus 250 plus 250. So the total is 1,000 grams.
Absolutely correct.
And 1,000 grams is equal to 1 kg. That means now we have 1 kg of jalebis. Brother, I have understood. Yay!
Very good.
Hey kids, look, here comes the father. Go help him to get the goods out of the cart.
Okay. Neetu, can you tell which will weigh more? 2 kgs of wheat or 500 grams of suji?
Rather suji, as 500 is greater than 2.
Yes, Neetu, you are right. But I have asked which is greater, 2 kgs or 500 grams. Focus on the units.
Oh, yes, right, brother. 1 kg means 1,000 grams. So 2 kgs would be equal to 2,000 grams.
Right.
Now, units of both are same, 2,000 grams and 500 grams. So wheat will weigh more because 2000 grams is greater than 500 grams.
Very good. Now try to hold both the packets. 2 kilograms of wheat and 500 grams means half a kg packet of suji.
Yes, brother. The packet of suji is lighter than the packet of wheat.
What are you both doing?
Brother is teaching me about kilograms and grams.
Oh, that's great. So, what have you learnt?
We measure light items in grams and heavy items in kilograms.
Yes, right. Now tell me, if we add 2 kgs of wheat, 5 kgs of rice, half a kg of suji and 1.5 kgs of sugar, what will be the total weight?
Let me try. Units of 2 kgs and 5 kgs are same. So this will give 7 kgs.
Right.
Half a kg suji means 500 grams.
You have become so intelligent, Neetu.
1.5 kgs of sugar means 1 kg and 500 grams.
Absolutely correct.
500 grams and 1 kg. If we add 500 grams to it, the weight would be 1 kg and 1000 grams. We can also say that the total is 2 kgs, as 1000 grams is equal to 1 kg. And 1 kg plus 1 kg gives 2 kg. That the unit of 7 kilograms and 2 kilograms is same. So if we add both of them, we'll get 9 kgs.
Right. Very good, Neetu.
Hey, why have we bought so many small packets of tea?
Shopkeeper did not have the large packet. So I brought 10 small packets of 50 grams.
Neetu, can you tell me what will be the total weight of 10 50 grams of such packets?
Let me add 50 up to 10 times.
Neetu, here you can also multiply 50 by 10.
Oh yes, brother, it would be the same thing. 50 multiplied by 10 gives 500. So, 500 grams.
Mom, Father has brought half a kg of tea leaves.
I was already told this by my daughter.
Okay, now tell me, if I make puris using 350 grams of wheat out of the 2 kilograms we have, then how much wheat will be left with us?
We have to subtract 350 grams from 2 kilograms.
And the first step for doing this is...
Kids, you can pause the video and calculate the answer.
To make sure that the units are same.
According to you, what should be the unit of both the items?
Gram, I can easily subtract with this.
How come?
2 kilograms mean 2000 grams.
Yes, right.
From this, I'll subtract 350 grams.
Absolutely correct.
On subtracting 350 from 2000, we are left with 1650. Now, 1000 grams means 1 kg. So Dad will be left with 1650 grams of wheat.
Wow! You have done it so well! So kids, in this video, we learned about the measuring units of weight and the relationship between kilograms and grams. Between kilogram and gram, misconceptions. In this video, we will learn about some misconceptions related to measuring units of weight, kilograms and grams. Hey kids, do you remember about the three children of Gopal and Radha, Shyam, Neetu and Mohan? Let's see what Neetu is doing today.
Brother, look at these two bags. Both of them has half a kg written on it. But the quantity of cotton is much more than the quantity of pulses.
Yes, Neetu, you are absolutely correct.
Brother, how is it possible?
Neetu, this is because cotton is very light. So more amount of cotton is needed to make half a kg of it. Pulses are heavier than cotton. So a very less amount of it is enough to make half a kg of it.
Oh, that's why the amount of cotton is so large.
Yes, Neetu. It is not necessary that if the weight of two objects is the same, when the quantity will also be the same. See, the weight of these four items is same, but their quantities are different.
Yes, brother.
You had just picked a packet of 100 grams of jeera and I picked a packet of 1 kg of suji.
Yes, brother.
Which of these two packets was heavier?
Your packet of suji.
Why?
Because the packet of suji is of 1 kg and 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams.
Absolutely correct.
So 1000 grams of suji is heavier than 100 grams of jeera. And if we put 100 grams of packets together, then their total weight would be 1000 grams, which would be equal to 1 kg of suji.
Neetu, you are getting very smart.
Yes, brother, like this, 5 packets of 100 grams dry chilies weigh the same as 500 grams of pulses.
You said it right. Dry chilies are lighter than pulses. So 5 packets of 100 grams dry chilies is equivalent to 1 packet of 500 grams of pulses.
On adding 5 packets of 100 grams, we'll get 500 grams. That is why both of them are equal.
So Neetu, now you understood. While comparing the weight of items, It doesn't depend on the number of items. Instead, it depends upon the measuring units of weight.
Brother, will you play with me?
Yes, sure. But first tell me, which of these two is more heavier? This big balloon or this small ball?
What, brother? As the size of the balloon is large, it would be more heavy.
It's not necessary that if the size of an object is large, it would also weigh more. Try holding both of these.
Yes, brother, the balloon is so light. Oh yeah, just now we have seen how a large quantity of cotton was equal to the weight of comparatively less quantity of pulses.
Yes, now you understood well.
Kids, always remember, the weight of an object doesn't depend upon how big or small it is, while it depends upon the heaviness of an object. So, kids, in this video, we learned about some misconceptions related to measuring units of weight, kilograms and grams.